Mwaniki, a resident of Malalani in Endau Kitui East, who led the authorities to the location where 34-year-old Musharraf Abdallah, alias Alex Shikanda, 30-year-old Joseph Juma Odhiambo, and 35-year-old Mohammed Ali Abikar were captured, is a relieved man this evening. He believes he played his role in defending the country against future terror acts, whether he gets it or not. That reward we're talking about. And as Wahiga Mora tells us, the government has heightened vigilance and surveillance across the country so as to deal with potential terror threats.
It was near a remote village in Mwingi East constituency, near the border of Kitui and Tana River counties, an estimated 160 kilometers from the Committee Maximum Security Prison, where the escape chronicles of three terror convicts came to an abrupt halt. 34-year-old Musharraf Abdallah, 30-year-old Joseph Juma Odhiambo, and 35-year-old Mohammed Ali Abikar had found their way to this location on a journey that appeared to have Somalia as their final destination. But they had not predicted how vigilant the locals here could be.
Nilipata habari jana jioni kuwa magaidi sugu watatu ambao walitoroka kamiti Maximum Prison Center walikuwa wamefika Endau Malalani Ward. Nilirudi kwangu nyumbani na nikalala, nikaamka asubuhi mwendo wa saa 2. Na nikapendelea sana kuenda pande hiyo magaidi wako.
By a stroke of luck, Paul chanced upon security agents as he continued to track the escapees.
Hapo nikapata askari watatu wa KPR. Na kwa sababu nilikuwa naogopa ya kwamba hao magaidi wanaweza kuwa wamejami na silaha hatari, nikawafahamisha na nikawaeleza jinsi kiatu inafanana. Waliniambia turudi nyuma, tuende tukaangaliwa magaidi. Kilomita kama 4 au 5 kutoka kwa bwawa la Engamba, tuliwapata wamekaa mahali chini wakiwa watatu. Tukafanikiwa kushika moja, wawili wakatoroka.
After dispatching one to the cells, they continued their search for the others.
Tukangana, hao magaidi tukakimizana nao, muda wa saa 1:30 na tukaweza kuwakamata.
The government had promised a 60 million Kenya shillings reward for anyone who could provide information that could lead to the arrest of the three.
Maybe for the Kenyans who offered information, will they get the bounty?
No. We are not going there at the moment. let's be speculative about this. We are going to work on this meticulously, as my colleagues have said.
Mimi, kama mwananchi mzalendo, natarajia serikali itatimiza ahadi yake. Tumengangana sana.
Meanwhile, tonight, the government has heightened vigilance and surveillance to deal with potential terror threats across the country.
Around us, we have challenges. Please let us be very careful and let's be watchful. This is the time to maintain a lot of care in the things that we do. And we will discuss some more as we go along. We have effected very far-reaching changes.
Matiangi further adding that the prison service will work closely with the Ministry of ICT to install modern, technology-driven security monitoring systems in the prisons and other correctional facilities. This as 6 Committee Maximum Security Prison warders, including the head of the institution, Charles Mutembei Gerard, and his deputy, were arraigned at the Kahawa Law Courts over the escape of 3 terror convicts. Wahiga Mwaura, Citizen TV.